Hello everyone, Sharon here again. In this answer video, I will explain you the answers of the question about the bioreactor that is applied for the production of baker's yeast. I've already made a sketch and written down the necessary information of this question. The first thing that you have to do is calculating the amount of gas bubbles in the bioreactor. To do this, we first calculate the volume of the bioreactor,
which is volume BO is equal to the height of the reactor times P times the radius squared. So this is half of the diameter, which is 2.5 meters. So this is 15 meters times P times 2.5 squared is equal to 295 cubic meter.
The volume fraction for the gas bubbles and the yeast cells is for both 30%. So V of the volume of the cells is equal to the volume of the bubbles,
which is 0.3 of 295 meters. Cubic meter is 88.4 cubic meter.
The volume of a single bubble is volume bubble is 4 of third times P times R to the third, which is the radius. So again, we have to divide this by 2, which is 2.5 millimeter is 2.5 times 10 to minus third meter. So this gives a bubble volume of one single bubble of 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8 cubic meter. So the amount of bubbles is easy calculating. It's just dividing, I call it n bubbles, is the volume of the bubbles in total divided by the volume of one bubble, which is 88.4 divided by 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8. And if you fill this in carefully, you will find that the amount of bubbles in the bioreactor is 1.3 to the minus 9. You can do the same for the cells. You calculate the volume of one cell, which is 4 divided by 3 times P times the radius to the third, which is this. And you also have to realize that the radius of the cell is the diameter divided by 2, and of course it has to be in meters because that's the SI unit. And then you get 2.5 times 10 to the minus 6 third is 6.5 times 10 to the minus 17, so that's quite smaller than the bubble, the gas bubble. And the amount of cells is then the volume of all cells together divided by the volume of one cell. And if you fill this in carefully, then you will find 1.3 times 10 to the 18 as the amount of cells in the biofermenter. To answer the question, what is the average residence time in seconds of a single bubble in the reactor? I've made a new sketch. It's a sketch of the bubble with all forces that work on the bubble. You see the upward force, F up, and you see the gravity force and the drag force. In steady state, of course, the up force plus the drag force plus the gravity force is zero. And we know how to calculate all these forces. We start with the upward force. F upwards is V bubble times the density of the liquid, so that's water in this case, times the gravity. So this is V bubble we calculated already, which is 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8 times the density of the liquid, which is water, so 1000 times the gravity, which is 6.4 times 10 to the minus 4 newton. We can do the same for the gravity force, which is also the volume of one single bubble times the density of air, because you now have to fill in the air density, times the gravity. So this is 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8 times 1.4, which is the density of air, times 9.81, which is 9 times 10 to the minus 7 newton. The drag force is the drag coefficient times P times the radius squared times 1 over 2 times the density of the liquid times the velocity. And the velocity is the one we have to calculate. Because this is a stirred bioreactor, we know that there is a turbulent flow. So if you look in the graph, then we see that for Reynolds number above 10 to the third, we always will find a drag coefficient of 0.47. But using this information, we can write the equation for the velocity, which is the square root of Fd divided by the drag coefficient times P times the radius of the bubble times 1 over 2 times the density of the liquid. If we use the stationary state, we can see that the drag force is equal to minus the gravity force minus the upward force. But of course, the signs of the forces have to be changed, because F upwards is positive and this are negative. So we have to say this is plus, and then we will find the square root of the upward force minus the gravity force divided by drag coefficients times P times the radius squared times 1 over 2 times the density of the liquid. And if we fill this in carefully, we will find which is 0.37 meter per second. The height of the reactor is 15 meters. So the average residence time of a single bubble is then the height divided by the velocity is 15 divided by 0.37, and that is 40 seconds. For the last part of the question, we assume that a total gas flow rate of 5.9
squared meter per second in the reactor. This is much higher than the velocity of a rising bubble without a gas flow. So in reality, the bubbles rise much faster. So the average residence time is now the volume of all the bubbles divided by the total gas flow. So this is the volume of the bubbles divided by the gas flow rate, which is 88.4 divided by 5.9, and this is about 15 seconds. The reason that this is lower than for a single bubble is due to the drag that the bubbles exert on the liquid. This results in a liquid circulation profile with a higher average bubble rise velocity relative to the reactor. Thanks for watching this video, and if you have other questions, you can always post it on the forum. And don't forget to answer questions of your colleague students.